allow the tree to grow. Having a strong root is the basis for having strong martial arts. I remember that scene from The Karate Kid where Miyagi tells Daniel he needs to have strong roots in his practice in order to branch out and grow, like a bonsai.
Just like bonsai, choose own way grow because root strong. You choose own way do karate, same reason.
Yeah, but I do it your way.
One day you do own way.
I know it's kind of a silly way to make a point, but there's some real solid martial wisdom in that concept. Too many times, martial artists are all about preserving the martial arts that were passed down to them, but they get too bogged down on technique and lose sight of the principle behind each technique. Or maybe more accurately stated, they get so concerned with performing the technique exactly how their master performed it without learning the essence behind it so that they can better understand how to make the technique their own.
Mine.
That doesn't necessarily mean changing a technique or doing away with it altogether, but first fully absorbing it and making it part of a strong foundation before being able to branch out and make it different. This concept is known most commonly in the Japanese styles as SHUHARI. And as always, we try to utilize the Korean terminology whenever possible. SHUHARI, translated in Korean, is known as BOSU PA BUNLI. BOSU PA BUNLI roughly translates to keep, to fall, to break away. BOSU, to protect, obey. Traditional wisdom, learning fundamentals, techniques, heuristics, and proverbs. PA, to detach, digress. Breaking with tradition, detachments from the illusions of self. Bunli, to leave, separate, transcendence. There are no techniques or proverbs. All moves are natural, becoming one with spirit alone without clinging to forms and transcending the physical. In regards to Pilsung Moo Do and its roots in traditional Tang Soo Do and Taekwondo, we have come to adopt this principle of a fully evolving martial art that holds dear important traditional principles and concepts, but at the same time grows and learns from those concepts, is truly alive and changes with the times to stay fresh and relevant in an ever-changing modern world. To further illustrate what BOSU PA BUNLI, or SHUHARI, is, I'd like to reference a quote by Aikido master Endo Seishiro. He says, "It is known that when we learn or train in something, we pass through the stages of SHUHARI. These stages are explained as follows. In SHU, we repeat the forms and discipline ourselves so that our bodies absorb the forms that our forebears created. We remain faithful to these forms with no deviation. Next, in the stage of Ha, once we have disciplined ourselves to acquire the forms and the movements, we make innovations. In this process, the forms may be broken and discarded. Finally, in Ri, we completely depart from the forms, open the door to creative technique and arrive in a place where we act in accordance with our heart and mind desires, unhindered while not overstepping laws." So getting back to our tree analogy, we want to have strong, immovable roots, a powerful trunk, flexible branches and leaves, and also the ability to produce seeds that will eventually break away, become free, and turn into new trees in their own right. I hope that makes sense.
Oh, I get it. Oh, very cute.
I think being able to innovate in how we perform our techniques is important, But I also believe that it's equally important to be willing to evolve in our training methods and practices as well. Supplementing line work and forms practice with more modern pad work and sparring. Not sparring in the point/competition style, but similarly to how the BJJ community uses flow rolling to help students learn to chain different techniques together, and then finally progressing to full resistance drills. These are things that most karate styles are lacking. The idea of pressure testing what we practice is one of the only ways to truly see what we'd be capable of in a live situation. But it's the most uncomfortable parts of practice that we tend to shy away from, but probably the most necessary. We will explore this topic in a future video. So how long should it be before we branch out? When is our root strong enough? It's tough to say. Everyone is different. Skill levels vary depending on how many years spent training. Some might think it's black belt level, but I would disagree. I wouldn't measure it in years spent or getting a black belt or any rank for that matter. I would make the case for when the practitioner begins to see a certain level of mushin in their training or having an empty mind, when most of the techniques become second nature to the point of not really thinking about them at all. It's tough to put a time limit on that, but I would say at minimum 20, 25 years of dedicated practice, at least, maybe longer. It varies from person to person. If you spend that amount of time in your chosen style, then you should have a good solid root by that time. To a beginner or someone who has not yet achieved the rank of black belt, that might seem like an eternity to them, but I would suggest being patient and enjoy the journey. You'll know when you're ready. And as always, remember to continue your training.